What's good, y'all? Eric July here, front man of BackWordz. And considering all the craziness going on, I wanted to give you our perspective and then give you an update on what we all have in store for you. There's a lot of unrest breaking out around this country, some justified, some not. This is following the events of a man being unjustly murdered by way of the cops in Minneapolis. Now, everybody's speaking about the fallout from that event, including many artists and entertainers. There's no shortage of corny-ass white dudes within this scene that got guilt-tripped into speaking up or proving themselves to be allies. But the issue of the state aggression is not something that is new to us. This is just another murder committed by that criminal institution. But we've already discussed it. Remember this? For example, when a cop shooting a black man, you focus on the racism, ignoring all the statism, holding signs, riding. It's not about to save him, cause you must have forgot that that's the power that you gave him. Criminal justice reform is a euphemism for a bunch of dumb foolish slaves with Stockholm Syndrome. If you also listen to statism, demon rat, democracy sucks, let me live, statheist, they're all on the same album and go through some of the things that I'm talking about in this video and maybe even something that you're experiencing right now. We've been there and we've done that. We've been talking about this since we formed. And if you know me personally, I've been doing it since before that. We've always been anti-state and we aren't against just the cops when it's socially acceptable. And this is the point and why we don't take most of you guys seriously and aren't at all optimistic about what's going to happen on the other side of this. Keep in mind that some of the same people, including the blue checkmark musicians, were advocating government-imposed lockdowns enforced by cops, which put 40 million people out of work and destroyed people's livelihoods. They were snitching on their neighbors and were claiming that you were going to kill their grandmas. They were advocating disarming you in any fight against tyranny, as they wanted policies to make it more difficult for you to own a gun or certain kinds of guns. They clutched their pearls at the idea that a band such as ours would dare to advocate against taxes because it funds those criminals that kill innocents here and abroad. So much of their gripes are either morally grandstanding or they don't understand that they advocate policies that are diametrically opposed. So it's of no surprise that many of them are justifying looting and property destruction. It's because they don't really have any principles. We find acts of aggression wrong altogether, and we see both the cops and the looters as enemies of liberty. It doesn't mean they're equal, they're just both enemies of liberty. We aren't brainless. We are capable of having two different positions at the same time. I'm not even saying that protests should be peaceful. We are saying that you should only direct it towards the aggressors, not your innocent neighbors. The only people making sense right now are the ones taking it directly to the precincts and the government buildings and so forth. The idiots that don't actually care about black lives or state aggression are the ones destroying other people's private property and then trying to justify it because insurance. Many of them justify this bad behavior because they feel like those businesses again have insurance, or they don't see how anti-economic it is to burn your community down, if they're even from there, because you don't have enough sense to target the actual aggressors. Some of these businesses don't even have the insurance that would cover them in this sense. Some of them are even black owned and aren't owned by rich people. And virtually all of them employ non-rich people that are now out of jobs, and they provide goods for non-rich people in that community. Under no circumstance is it excusable to target innocents because you call yourself being mad at oppression. Under no circumstance is it okay to damage your neighbor's property simply because you think you have to do it now since they weren't listening before. That's how irrational people operate. You could just direct your issue towards the actual aggressors. We have it on tape. We know who killed George Floyd and others like him. And we know what that institution is. It's not the black-owned wig shop that had his knee on the back of that man's neck. So we aren't doing any fundraising or gonna try to guilt trip you into donating to some people or cause that wanted us dead prior to May 25th anyway. On the local side of things, I'm in the process, of course, assisting my friends, family members, and other like-minded individuals in my area to get involved with firearms, understand firearms, get trained on firearms so they can protect themselves, their families, their property. And when all is said and done, that pencil neck band dude that is saying all cops are bastards and Black Lives Matter is going to go right back to advocating for state socialism and justify its existence. BackWordz, however, will still be in our advocacy because we oppose the state year round, not just when we are told to be mad and fed up. We oppose it consistently. And when you're ready to have that talk, we'll be around. We're ready. On the other note, let's talk about our fans. Thanks to all of you guys for the support. I know many of you are anticipating when more music will drop because it has been a minute. Our second album is almost done. It's mostly done, but it's not entirely done as we still have some things to record, some things to do. Remember, we do the whole self-release thing, so there's a lot of stuff that kind of goes into it. Things that maybe a label or something would do, we do ourselves. The lockdowns, though, from this virus have really halted our urgency, I'm not going to lie, because once it's done, we don't know the album, that is, we don't know when we'll be able to drop it or tour or anything like that. The good news is I just moved and I'm almost done building out my home studio, so I'll be finishing and dropping multiple rap mixtapes to sort of hold you guys over, and all of these will be free. So your patience is much appreciated. Stay tuned and don't fall for the okie doke.